Hello, Atticus authors, and hopefully maybe a few future Atticus authors. Welcome back to the Atticus Training Zone. My name is Monique Danielle. If we have not met before, I'm the educational curator here over at Atticus. So we did an update to the user interface, which is basically just how things look. This was mainly so that we can prepare for future updates. These live streams are really here to help you get comfortable and familiar and find where everything is. And then in the future, there will be now lots of space and a really strong foundation for all of the plans that are yet to come with Atticus. Our goal overall with the program is to become a one-stop shop for authors. We want you to be able to jump into Atticus and do everything that you need to do from writing to publishing your book, or at least getting publish-ready files to send off to a publisher. Currently, you can do all of your writing and your formatting in Atticus, but we do have a lot of exciting features yet to come in terms of plotting and outlining and the big one, which is collaboration. So this new user interface has set the stage to allow us to start rolling out some of those updates. So that's the why behind this update. But to get started, I'm just going to jump in and I'm going to share my Atticus account with you. So you should be seeing that on the screen now. And this is the new look of the dashboard. If you are not seeing this, or if at any point in the future you ever kind of see a white screen when you try to log in, sometimes Atticus does need to be refreshed. This is sometimes because of the program itself or because your browser has updated and that has created a need for just a refresh of everything. So if ever you sign into Atticus and it does not look like this, what you'll want to do is just come over to the profile icon in the top right here and just click the logout button. If you don't see it, then you can just skip to the next step. But once you're logged out, you can just sign right back in. And then you're going to want to do what we call a hard refresh. So on a Windows computer, you're going to press Control Shift R. On a Mac computer, you will press Command Shift R. That covers most devices. And it just gets everything refreshed. It's kind of like turning your computer off and on again. You may have noticed that it also exported a file whenever you log out of Atticus, or if you click this Save button up here, which says Content Backup, it will export what is called a JSON file. This is a snapshot of your entire account on Atticus, which can be used to restore everything to that exact point in time. Now, one of the beautiful things about Atticus is that it does automatically save everything that you're writing as you're writing it. So if you go write a chapter today and then go to bed, come back on tomorrow, all your content will be there. It does back up into the cloud. Whenever you press that backup button or when you log out, though, it creates like a timestamp. So our programmers, if anything were to happen, if you accidentally deleted a book or you wanted to go back to a previous version or anything like that, having that point in time timestamp really makes a difference when our programmers have to go and check the archive for something. I'm getting ahead of myself, though. Let's look at the new dashboard. So all of the features are the same as what you had before, it just looks a little different. So now up at the top, you have your upload a book, start a new book, or create a new box set features. Really easy to use as always. To the top right, this is a new section here. It will link you straight through to our tutorials page on our website. That is where we keep written copies of any of our tutorials. So we walk you through pretty much every single feature that's available on Atticus and how to use it. And these include screenshots as well. So you can learn at your own pace. If there's something you want to explore, you're not quite sure how to do something, you can click through to our tutorials and you will likely find some information there to help you through the process. At any point, if our YouTube videos or our tutorials or the chatbot on our website is just not giving you the information you need, you can absolutely always write into our support email. We will take very good care of you. We have an amazing support team that continues to grow because we find it so valuable to have support ready for you at all times. So with your books in your account, yours may be more full or less full than mine, but all your most recent works will show front and center. And then if you scroll down, you will now see your master pages. So this used to be tucked away in a little gallery on its own, and you could either click through to the gallery or you could access your pages, your master pages in a book. you can now access it right from your home dashboard. You can open up a page, you can make a change, and you can apply it right from your dashboard here. Or you can still do it from within in a book as well. That is still an option. Now, if you click See All, either by the master pages beside your recent works here, or if you come up to the top center and click My Books, you get a more full view of everything that is included in your account currently, all of the works that you have been working on in Atticus. This includes all of your books, all of your box sets, all of your master pages. You can sort them by all, by books, or simply by your master pages. You can search by the title of your book, the author, if you're using various pen names, or if you have at any point set up a version or a project, you can sort and filter by those here. So I know I've set up a whole set of workbooks, so I can type that in here and only the workbooks will show. You can also sort by this way. Currently, your options are recently added, date modified, or alphabetic. By project or version will be added to this list very soon. We just have to make a few small tweaks and they will be back. You can sort your dashboard here either by the standard grid view or in list view if you are more comfortable this way, whichever you prefer. And then, as always, to get into a book, you just have to click on your title thumbnail and it opens up the book to the writing editor. A few things have changed here, so I'll go through all of the different features. This isn't a tutorial on how the features work. It is just kind of a lay of the land, where to find what. So the left navigation panel, you have all of your chapters in the body section. You have your front matter here. You have still the add a chapter button, and you've got your extra pages where if you want to add some of the templates, the preset layouts, if you need to replace a title page, or if you want to add a full page image, this is also where you can insert any of your pre-created master pages. And if you need to import another docx file into the book you've already started working on, you can do that here. Some of the differences is you used to have your book title up at the top here and you would click on that to open your book details page. Now it is a really easy to access button, so you can click the button to edit your book details. This is a really good example of how we've tried to streamline everything. So instead of having to scroll down a long page full of details, it's a little bit more well-organized, easy to find everything, more white space, more just easier to see, but all of the content is still there. So you can have your book details here. You have your publisher details if you want to add those. You can still upload your ebook cover. So also in the book details section, you can do your exports here. You can export to EPUB, PDF, or DocX files. And this download snapshot button here is a backup of just the book that you're working on. So we already talked about the backup content here, which exports a JSON file and backs up your entire account on Atticus. This one here will export a JSON file that is just the individual book you're working on, and that creates a snapshot or a timestamp of this book in your cloud archive. Going back into the writing editor, up here at the top, you have your standard toolbar, which hasn't changed very much. You still have all of your settings here. The big difference is at the end, you used to have the sprint timer and the apply smart quotes. Those have been relocated. So I will show you where those are in just a moment when we kind of get to that section. But otherwise, the main writing toolbar is pretty much the same. The chapter heading, the chapter menu options used to have a little gear icon right beside the title. It has now just moved to the right. This is just adding a little bit more consistency because these icons are always to the right of whatever you're working on. So your chapter menu options are just over here. These will override any settings that you have set for your theme overall for the book. So if in just one chapter you don't want to have the heading, you can select that here. Or if you want to hide it in the table of contents, that sort of stuff is in the icon here. We used to have the saved notification up here in the top right. For consistency with other programs, we've just moved it down here, which is where you will often see it in most programs. So this will tell you that your work is saving. Also, due to popular demand, we've made it a little bit easier for you to export your content to DocX. So you can find that button in the writing panel right down at the bottom here. This is the new home for your sprint timer. So you can select that here. And this is where you can see your word count. So you can set it to the book as a whole, the chapter you're working on, or if you have a selection highlighted. This used to be a menu that you could click on and get your word count. We found that a lot of authors want to know their word count at a glance. They want to know how far they've got to get to their daily count or where they are in their book. So having this set so that it is always there was a popular request and makes it a little bit easier for you to see at all times now. The right panel, you used to be able to pull out a separate menu called the More Tools menu. It's just a little bit more streamlined here, but all the features are the same. So you have your writing editor preferences here. This is just for your comfort as a writer. It affects the writing section only. It does not export anything that you want to export. You will set up in the formatting portion. So if you're writing in Atticus, this is just how it makes it more comfortable for you as a writer. You can also do your find and replace for chapter or book level. This is pretty much the same as it always was. Your goals are more or less the same as they always were, the book goal and the writing habit. And this is where the Smart Quotes applicator has moved. So you used to see the little icon up here letting you know if there were any inconsistencies in your quotes, and that is now in the sidebar, and you can still apply. As always, it works the exact same way. It's just a slightly new location. The other one major change is you can now open the previewer right from the writing panel. You don't have to be in formatting mode to open this. You can come down to the very bottom right and open the previewer here. You can still change to print mode or any other device setting that you would like. And you can close that out if you want to have a more distraction-free writing experience. So that's just a slightly new location. So you can add that down here. That's the writing editor. Now I'm going to jump into formatting. So once your book is all written and you want to create your custom theme, this is almost the same as it was before. You don't have your left navigation panel here. Instead, you have a lot more space to see everything. You can go through the Atticus pre-created themes, or you can work on one that you've customized yourself. You can click the three dots beside any theme that you want to work on, and you can edit it to make it your own. This is where things start to look a little bit different. But again, our goal here was make it a little bit sleeker, a little bit easier to find everything, quicker to navigate through. Instead of having to scroll down a huge long page, you can now access a menu and jump right to the portion that you want to deal with. Everything other than that works the same. So you can turn on or off certain elements if you do not want to have them in your book. You can add your chapter image here. You can still move it around. You can use your background image if you choose. All of these are pretty much the same as they were, just slightly different layout. Paragraph settings, subheading settings, scene break, and notes are all more or less exactly the same, just easier to jump to using this side panel here. Where it did change a little bit is the print settings. So for your print book, you do have some extra options that are not set in the ebook version. So your ebook version, a lot of features are set by the individual user device, including like the font choices, and you don't have to choose the page size because it just depends on the device, that sort of thing. But you do need to have these settings really nailed down for the print version of your book. So in the print layout here, you have your margins, and you can size your indents here if you're using indents in your book. You can choose your alignment to be either justified or hyphenated or both. Keep options refers to if you have either an ornamental break or a subheading that ends as the last line on one page and then the following paragraph gets bumped to the next page. Keep options will keep that ornamental image or subheading with the next paragraph, so they get bumped together. Layout priority down here, you can choose this. I always emphasize the fact that this is one of the biggest areas that book formatters really earn their high-priced keep. The best of both is the Atticus algorithm, which first prioritizes for widows and orphans, and then it goes through and balances the pages. This will never be 100% perfect absolutely all of the time, but it does the best job at mitigating both of those features with literally the click of a button. So it can save absolutely hours off of the formatting process. So that's the print layout options. The typography refers to the font in your print book. So you can choose your body font and size and line spacing here. The header and footer is the running text along the very top and bottom of the page, usually where your page number is. You can choose your layout from the options here. There's quite a few and you can choose those. You can set the font and size here as well. And then finally, you do have the trim sizes. So you can set the size your book that will be printed at. And then you have your previewer. You can see how everything looks. Again, you can, of course, switch it over to print and see how it looks in print. You can flip through your pages. You can even jump through different chapters. And then when you're fully confident that everything is how you want it to be, you can export to PDF or EPUB using these buttons down here, or again, as you saw before in the edit book details. So that is a quick overview of where everything is located now since the update has occurred.